Today it's a battle of unbeatens as Cal takes on Oregon. Early control of the Pac-10 is at stake.
I think today they've got a pretty tough test against a scrappy Oregon team that got some confidence last week, beating a Big Ten team in Champaign, beating Illinois 13-7.
Now this will be something that's interesting to watch. Cal's offensive coordinator is Denny Shuler. For the last 6 years before this season, Shuler was the defensive coordinator at Oregon. Now, usually people say that doesn't make that much of a difference, but Oregon definitely thinks that that will be an advantage for the Bears today.
Well, that's what Rich Brooks is saying, but even though that is Denny Shuler defense there and he knows the personnel, ultimately the players do dictate what happens on the field. Conversely, I think that a lot of people were scratching their heads when they hired a defensive coordinator to run the offense for the Bears. All he's done is put together an offense that leads the Pac-10 in total offense and passing efficiency. What Denny's shown is that if you're a good coach with a solid philosophy, it doesn't make any difference what side of the ball you're on.
Yeah, Dave Barr is the leader.
I think Dave is throwing the ball accurately. He's holding on to the ball. He's making right decisions.
Barr's counterpart at quarterback is Danny O'Neill for the Ducks, a guy who, like Barr, has thrown in only 2 interceptions all year.
Well, he's progressed in a lot of the same respects as Dave Barr has. And, as O'Neill has progressed, so have the Oregon Ducks. He has got a great passing efficiency. He's at 13th in the nation in total offense. Asked Artie Gigantino, the defensive coordinator of the Bears, if they were going to put some pressure because he's not a big quarterback, 6'2", 180. He said, hey, we blitzed him last year, knocked him down, but he got up. He's a very tough player.
4-0 California against 3-0 Oregon. The Bears trying to get off to a 5-0 start for just the second time since 1952. The other time being, of course, that 91 season that saw Cal go to the Citrus Bowl. California has won the toss and will receive it down at there, and the Bears will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. But Barr definitely in command of this Cal offense, and a little twist for the Bears as they come out right away on first down with 2 wide receivers out to the right, and Marty Holly, the lone running back, now going in motion to the left for the Bears. Barr with time and throwing over the middle to Mike Caldwell has first down yardage across the 30 to the 31. Here's the California offense. It's Barr at quarterback. Marty Holly and Lindsey Chapman are the starting running backs. Mike Caldwell and Damian Semien are the wide receivers, and Brian Remington is the tight end. Up front, Todd Stussy, Todd Blackwell, Eric Malum, Frank Beatty, and Brian Thury, as the Bears have a second down and 10 on their own 32-yard line. Barr will pitch it to Chapman. Chapman out to the 35 before he stopped. Up front for Oregon, Gary Williams, Celia Malapai, and Romeo Bandison. Then it's John Tomopeo, Dave Massey, Jeremy Asher, Ernest Jones, and in the secondary, Molden, Cota, Lewis, and Walker. Second down and 7 after that pickup of 3 by Chapman. And Chapman trying to get around the corner, has running room out to the 40, the 45, and to midfield before he's finally dragged down. 49-yard line of Oregon.
Well, Joe, here's a nice little off-tackle play. Marty Holly leading through, engages the outside linebacker, and Lindsey is doing the same things that he's shown the last 3 weeks. Great pickup, and the Bears are moving the ball well here in the first series.
And this is an Oregon defense that has not allowed a score in the first quarter. So the Bears will be trying to go against an Oregon trend so far in 1993. Here comes a rush again. Bandison's after him, but Barr with some running room. And throws intended for Caldwell, but it was behind him, and the Bears will have to punt it away.
Well, Dave's saying there that Mike should have worked back the other way, but it looked on a scramble drill, you've got to work towards the quarterback. Mike just crossed the field, and Dave just threw the ball a little bit behind him.
But back deep is Brian Brown for Oregon. Cal has punted just 3 times in the last 2 games, so Longwell has not had a lot of practice during game time. It's a low, wobbly kick away that will take a Cal roll, go inside the 15, and down near the 10-yard line where the Bears will down it. Here's the Oregon offense. Danny O'Neill, the quarterback, Juan Shedrick and Sean Burwell are the running backs. Kristen McLemore and Derek Deadwilder, the wide receivers. Josh Wilcox is the starting tight end. Up front, it's Steve Harden, Eric Barnes, Tom Curran, Mike DeFonso, almost a relative, and Justin Stark on the interior line. McLemore and Deadwilder come wide to the left now. Cal showing blitz. And a quick pass out to McLemore. McLemore will be surrounded as Artis Houston finally makes the stop. Here's the starting defense for California. Up front, it's Upshaw, Stafford Evans, Bill Ayer, and Dwayne Clemens. The linebackers are Michael Davis, Paul Joyner, and Jared Willard. And in the secondary, it's Artis Houston and Ike Booth actually getting the start at corner instead of Jody Graham. Zobalt and Miles are the safeties. Second down and nine after a pickup of one on that last pass for the Ducks. Juan Shedrick busted out across the 10, near first down yardage. He needed to get just a little beyond the 15 and got about to the 15.
Transition there, getting him the ball on the first series here.
Third down and one now for Oregon as Shedrick came up a yard short. And they give it to Burwell. Burwell looking for first down yardage. I don't believe he got it.
Let's take another look at it. And Sean Burwell has been banged up this year. He's had a bad ankle and only played sparingly. Here he just spins off off tackle, a little bit short. Good defensive pursuit there by the Bears.
They did mark his forward progress now beyond the 15-yard line, and he did pick up the first down. So a first and 10 for Oregon as the Ducks move the sticks on their first offensive possession. McLemore goes in motion to the left, and they pitch it out to Burwell. Trying to get around the corner to the left side. He does. He's across the 20, out to the 25, and has the first down.
Well, Burwell, you saw a little bit of why he's probably going to be the leading carrier. He outruns on the right-hand side. You'll see Dwayne Clemens, who should have contained, and he just gets stalemated there. And Derek comes around here. Darryl Miles gets faked out a little bit, and he turns the corner and gets up some good yardage.
And I think we can already sense right now the Bears know this is a little bit different than Temple and San Jose State. O'Neal pitches it out to Burwell, has lots of running room. He's across the 35 to the 40, and then finally run out of bounds by Booth.
Great tight ends that can run. What they did on this last play is they split Willie Tate out. And
dead ball, personal foul, defense, 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
Yeah, that's going to hurt. But Willie Tate here, if you can see, he's on the left-hand side of your screen, is out in the slot, makes a great block right there on Eric Zobalt. And then we get a good move, good juke, and he gets out wide here, Ike Booth. And the rest of the Bears there a little bit late.
California called for that late hit out of bounds. That moves the ball all the way down to the 35-yard line of the Bears. So it's Shedrick and Burwell, the backs, behind O'Neal. That's Burwell going in motion to the left, and O'Neal back to pass. Throwing over the middle, complete to Detweiler to the 20, and then he's caught there. A good open field tackle by Ike Booth, but not before the Ducks pick up a first down.
I like what the Ducks are doing. They're trying to get Eric Zobalt out and spread him out a little bit more, and that's one of the philosophies. When he's out of there, they just don't have the great run support here. You see Danny steps back, crossing routes, and there's huge lanes. Jarrett Willard isn't able to get there. Ike Booth comes up with the tackle.
Now, first one has been two for two so far on its third down conversions. Now it's third and 11. O'Neal throwing for the end zone and has a receiver. Touchdown, Ducks. Dameron Ricketts making the catch for the touchdown. And Oregon jumps ahead 6-0. A 22-yard touchdown pass from Danny O'Neal to Dameron Ricketts. His kick is up and good. So back at Memorial Stadium, where the Oregon Ducks have put on an impressive 94-yard drive in 13 plays. Here was the last one to give him a 7-0 lead.
And what set this whole play up is Danny O'Neal looking to his right and controls the safety. That kept Jerrod Cherry right inside the hash marks. When he goes back to Ricketts, there's just a nice open seam, and you can see Cherry getting over there late. Touchdown. Artis Houston had a receiver to his side. He wasn't able to get over there. That was a nicely designed play by the Ducks.
We talked about tests for the Bears. No question that things are stepped up a notch this week when you come in and take on a Pac-10 opponent. And now this will be even a bigger test as the Bears down 7-0 in the first quarter. And Thompson will kick it off. Benjamin will take it at the 3, has trouble with the ball, now gets the handle, and gets away from one tackler at the 10, out to the 15, and the ball's on the carpet, and Oregon has recovered.
Well, now never really gets off to a good start here. He fumbles a ball on the initial kick, and sometimes that allows you for a big play, but guys just got down here and stripped the ball, and not good here.
Well, he ran into his blocker, it looked like. Now, the Bear defense will be tested as Oregon has its first and 10 at the California 17-yard line. O'Neal is going to be tackled finally by Zobalt as they move it to the California 12-yard line. Burwell changes direction, got some running room, trying to get to the end zone. He won't do that, but he does pick up a first down.
Let's take a look here. You know, you can see the difference in team speed. The Bears have faced teams the last 2 weeks that they've been superior to, and Dwayne Clemens is just outrun by Sean Burwell here. Otters Houston makes a nice stop to stop the Ducks on the 2-yard line.
Pitches it out to Burwell, and he stopped at the 2 and knocked out of bounds. Good defense by the Bears that time as Willard and Zomal came up to make the stop.
Darrell Miles had support. He came up, but he didn't quite get the contain angle he needed. Burwell still was able to get out of there and get outside wide, but Jarrett Willard, if you can see here, number 7, here's the support, boom, but he doesn't quite contain him, and there's Willard. Lateral movement, you can't ask for much better. That was a great defensive play, movement on both sides of the ball.
You can hear that pop all the way up here. No gain, so second down and goal on the 2. Now O'Neal wants to throw. Looking back to the left and has Willie Tate wide open for the touchdown. He went to his tight end, and just like that, Oregon has gone up by 2 touchdowns in this ballgame.
Keith Gilbertson just kind of wondering what the heck is going on here. It's kind of a reality check here in the first quarter where the Bears have outscored their opponents 52-9 in the first quarter and their first 4 wins.
We said it was a test when the Bears were down 7-0. Well, they're now down 14-0.
All the flow here is Danny O'Neal snaps the ball. It's going to the right-hand side. He looks off. Willie Tate is on the right-hand side, sneaks out underneath the coverage. Gerard Cherry was lulled by the flow to the right-hand side.
Tommy Thompson to kick it off to Benjamin once again. He takes the ball at his 5. Trying to get a lane up the middle. Has a little room across the 20 to the 25. Hangs on to the football out to the 27. And here's where the Bears have to stay patient and not try to get out of the game plan. We're still very early in the ball game. California has to do with what has been successful all season. Barr throwing over the middle. It's intercepted by Chad Cota. Cota at midfield and brought down at the 49-yard line.
Cota is a leading tackler on this team, and if we take a look at it, Mike was running an option route deep, about 20 yards, decided to go in. Cota just reading Dave Barr's eyes and just stays there as a rover, kind of in the deep secondary. Dave just didn't see Chad Cota. Nice interception.
So now the Bear defense will seriously be tested once again. That interception string comes to an end for Barr. And again, throwing long, Deadwater, he has him out there, touchdown Oregon. O'Neal to Derek Deadwater for 49 yards and a touchdown, and look out, it's now 20-0 Ducks.
Well, it's surprising to see O'Neal running because Gerard Willard just put the wood on O'Neal after that great throw, and he gets up. He is a competitor. He just got up a big play here. I can't believe the Ducks are taking this kind of a commanding lead.
And Thompson comes in for the extra point. It is 21-0, and those guys are ahead. We've been saying this a lot already in the first quarter. Tommy Thompson kicking off, the Bears receiving. Niall Benjamin with the ball at the 4. And gets out to the 15 or 16, and that's it. Here's the look at that last touchdown as Danny O'Neill's last 3 passes have gone for touchdown.
Well, check the protection out here. Dwayne Clemens, they've got some pressure, but Danny steps up here and gets the ball off, and Jarrett Willard just puts the big hit. But look at that. That's zone coverage. And, Deadwater beating them deep, that just cannot happen. It just can't happen. And there's been some turnover, and it's been an area of concern for Artie Gigantino. So an area that really hasn't been addressed yet.
First down and 5. Raynard Rutherford with his first carry of the ball game gets out across the 35. Brooks took over this program, took them to their first bowl in 26 years, back in 1989. And they've now been to bowls in 3 of the last 4 years. Second down and 3. Barr pitches it out to Chapman. Chapman does not get the first down.
Here's a strong safety. Chad Cota does a good job here. Lindsay will take the pitch. Cota will come up, force the play in there. You see Marty Hawley try to kick him out, but that's right. He wants Lindsay to cut underneath right into that pursuit of the Duck D. Bears. Just ran through the last 2 teams. It was like an inter-squad scrimmage.
Third down. Barr, here comes the rush. Massey had him. And pitches it out to Chapman, and Oregon will cover the football, I believe. Wait a minute, they're whistling it dead. Are they going to call that a forward pass or a lateral? That's the question. And now they're going to say Oregon's ball. And I don't know how they can say that when no one else can
see the football. Jeremy Asher, the inside linebacker for the Ducks, And you can see here, Dave just feels the heat all over, and he's just trying to get out of trouble. And he probably should have just sat down, but then kind of laterals it or tosses it backwards, and Lindsay can't get it. Asher's got it there, pops out. You know, nobody's got possession. Then Eric Mallon knocks it out of bounds.
Now, that should be California's football, but what they called incorrectly was they said that Asher had possession and called it dead. That's when we heard the quick whistles. They whistled it dead right there.
That's it.
And that was an incorrect call on the part of the officials, but they had whistled it dead and called it an Oregon possession on the recovery by Asher. Back at Memorial Stadium, where I think the Bear defense has been tested already in this ballgame. Here's test number four. The Bears turn it over once again, deep in their own territory, and again, the Ducks trying to take advantage. Ricky Whittle going to be hit by Paul Joyner. He's going to be dragged all the way back to the 40-yard line as forward progress stopped. Second down and 13 after that loss of three. Shedrick bangs it forward before Clemens gets a hold of him. Well, this is when you really have to be disciplined. When you're down 21-0, it feels like everything's going against you. It's really easy to let those kinds of things happen, and all that does is worsen the situation. Third down and 8 now for the Ducks. O'Neal wants to pass, throwing for Deadwire, and incomplete. They'll mark it down at the 29-yard line, so a 39-yard attempt. Thompson has the distance. The ball hits the upright, and it falls through. It hit the right upright, and the ball went straight down and went across the crossbar.
Man, if that's an indication of today, huh?
Wow. Gives Oregon the lead at 24-0.
This guy's kicked a 56-yard field goal last year. He's got the distance. A little short there, but it hits the bar and drops right in.
Let's go downstairs to Glenn Kuyper. Glenn?
All right, thanks, Joe. You know, it's been a long time since these two teams played, and we're both undefeated. How about 58 years ago, back in 1935? Cal was 3-0, Oregon was 2-0. Cal won that game 6-0. Doesn't look like that's going to happen today, at least not so here in the first quarter. That's your history lesson day for you guys.
And Tommy Thompson has been doing a lot of kicking off in the first quarter. Will do so again. Unless this one goes back for a touchdown, Oregon's undefeated or unscored upon streak in the first quarter will continue. Benjamin takes it at the 10, gets across to the 20 to the 25-yard line, covers up and holds on to the football that time. California first and 10. As the Bears trail 24-0, and we begin the second quarter.
Bears are having a tough time getting any kind of flow here.
You know, and the Oregon defense was chastised by the coaching staff for allowing Montana to score 30 points in a 35-30 win. Montana won double-A school. The Bears on second down. Barr throws complete to Benjamin. And I think, Booz, it's not important that the Bears, you know, even try to match what Oregon did in the first quarter, but they definitely need to put a couple of scores, a couple of drives on the board before halftime and try to change this momentum around a little bit.
Yeah, you just keep the blinders on and kind of have confidence that you can incrementally move down and put a few points on the board and get some of it back.
Barr rolling. And now here comes the rush, and down he'll go. Chapman and Holly, the backs behind Barr. Barr's numbers, the one interception, the big one in that grouping there. Here comes the big rush, and Barr will go down. Asher was after him, David Massey. The Ducks coming with 10 players right up on the line of scrimmage. Now they back off a bit as Longwell boots a high spiral. But Brown takes it to 22 and gets not quite to the 30. O'Neal to pass on first down. Throwing complete to Detweiler. Had all kinds of time and then all kinds of room for Detweiler. And they're in Bear territory at the 35-yard line.
Well, that's an indication of the kind of production the Ducks have had today. O'Neal gets flushed out of the pocket, and they still pick up great yardage. Here he flushes right. Jody Graham's playing a little soft. Detweiler just comes back to him, and they make a nice completion there.
O'Neal changing the play at the line of scrimmage. And throwing for Deadwire, has it. He's out to the 20. Graham missed him initially.
The pre-snap alignment, the Bears are lining off, the corners are off about 10 yards. Looked like O'Neal just checked off to a quick hitch, two-step drop, boom, out there, and Jody's got to settle up. He's just screaming in there trying to make the hit. These guys are good athletes out on the perimeter. They make one juke, and they're off to the races.
As you would expect with this score, all the statistics as lopsided as the score at this point. Rich Brooks' team doing nothing wrong so far, and the Ducks came into this game figuring they're a little bit banged up, but they certainly haven't looked it. They're going to do a double pass, and they have Tate wide open in the end zone for a touchdown. It was O'Neal to McLemore to Willie Tate.
Well, you've got it. They ran it in a position on the field where you've got just enough area to get deep. Willie Tate was able to just get down there, and everybody was anticipating the quick screen of the wide receiver. They toss it deep.
So Tommy Thompson on the kick to try to make it 31-0 Oregon. And he hits the upright again, and this time it's no good. And here's that razzle-dazzle once again for the Ducks.
Well, they sell it really well. The Ducks just get out here and try to set it up as a quick screen. And you see number six out there, McLemore, just lays it right out, lets Willie Tate run over. Not a bad throw. Must be a former quarterback there.
A perfect throw from McLemore.
And you see Dwayne Clemens just didn't get his arms up in time. And the key is to get that thing and be loose out there. Paul Joyner, a little late. Dante DiPaolo fooled by the screen.
This has been all Oregon. 30-0 Ducks. 10:17 left in the second quarter. Thompson will kick it off. Houston will take it at the four for the Bears. Trying to get to the outside. Has a lane. He's to the 30. Cuts back at the 40 to the 45-yard line before he stops. 41-yard return by Artis Houston. And the Bears finally have something to get excited about. But they're still 55 yards away from the end zone.
You know, Dave Farr not doing that bad. He just hasn't had the ball that much. And then the one interception when he's trying to throw to Mike Caldwell down deep. Again, another turnover there. So it's been time of possession here, all Ducks.
And Cal's defense has not been able to stop the Ducks at all so far. Chapman bangs it out. Now Oregon showing all kinds of looks to Dave Barr. Lindsey Chapman gets around the corner. He needed to get by one more guy, but Isaac Walker came up from his cornerback spot to make the stop.
Those fullbacks, you know, they get real satisfaction. They may not get the carries, they may not get the yards, but when their tailback gets big yards, that's kind of their payoff.
Now they kind of have to take the same type of approach as an offensive lineman.
That's right.
Barr throwing it up, has the receiver out there, complete.
Expect Mike Caldwell to be the guy in the bump and run that you go deep. Dave Barr just checks off. Little fade route. He gets enough, positions himself, and goes up and gets the ball. Really nice job. Moulton's the top interceptor last year with four interceptions, and Mike just does a great job of protecting the ball and going up after it.
So the Bears now at the 22-yard line of the Ducks. And Barr will pass once again. Here comes the rush. He dumps it out to Chapman. Chapman across the 15. Bounces off two tacklers down to the 10. California could pick up a first down on this drive without getting in the end zone here. It's first and 10 from just outside the 10. Barr on play action. Here comes the rush. And he's going to be sacked all the way back at the 30-yard line.
I think they were trying to take advantage of the strong safety, Chad Cota. It's a play action, and Chad Cota has a tendency to come up and want to make the big hit. And Marty Hawley's trying to run a route against him, but Chad doesn't bite. Dave doesn't have enough time, and big loss.
And Barr, with lots of time this time, throwing for Benjamin. Benjamin will be brought down at about the 21-yard line.
That'll be real mentally tough on that.
Barr will work out of the shotgun on 3rd and 21. Stands in the pocket, has time for the end zone, throwing for Benjamin, and now a penalty flag does fly in their lane.
Well, Dante Lewis.
And again, it came from an official who was not really on the play. It came from an official who was quite a ways away.
Dave gets down here. And you can see the ball looks like it's tipped, but he doesn't. And I can't tell if it's tipped or not, but Nile did not have an opportunity there, and they get the flag.
First and goal now at the 3. Chapman. Bam. down to about the one.
You know, the left hand side of the Ducks defense is really the strength. They've got Ernie Jones, or Ernest Jones, who's really an All-American candidate, and then Romeo Bandison, that's the strength.
Chapman looking for the end zone and gets in for a California touchdown.
Pays off sometimes to go deep, take the big gamble, and draw the penalty. Dante Lewis on the pass interference there on Mount Benz.
So half that has been all Oregon. It is the Ducks 30, California 7. We'll be back with more from halftime. California's defense will be tested right away as we begin the second half here. It's 30 to nothing. Oregon leading the Bears as Bryant kicks it off for California. Whittle will take it two yards deep in the end zone, bring it out to the 10, and he's popped but keeps his feet and is then stopped short of the 20-yard line. Coming out and just putting a big hit on Whittle.
Scott Nady with a big hit.
Oh. Scott Nady met him at the 10, and Whittle able to keep his feet and keep going, but Whittle knows he got smacked there. Look at him.
You know, the Bears are trying to get something going. That's not what you want to do to start off the second half here.
But now Oregon with the ball first and 10 on its own 18-yard line. California trailing 30-7. The Bears need to make something happen right away to get back in this ballgame. Coming with the rush, O'Neal throws it up intended for McLemore, but incomplete. No, Deadweiler out there. But incomplete, pretty good coverage, and the Bears got a good pass rush that time.
You know, coming into this game, Rich Brooks said, you know, the one thing he was not comfortable with was the health of his team. All of his running backs, Sean Burwell, Dino Filio, Ricky Whittle, all banged up. You know, you would never have thought these guys were in the least bit injured. I mean, they've come out and performed, and, just incredible.
Yeah, that's kind of like UCLA last week, kind of lulling Stanford to sleep, saying they weren't a very good team. Second down and 10. Burwell is tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. James Stallworth making the play behind the line to trip up Sean Burwell.
Burwell was one of the guys with a pretty severe ankle injury that had not just played a little bit the last two games and was well enough to get on track today. And he's closing in on being the all-time Oregon Duck rushing leader.
They do move the ball out to the 22-yard line, but it's third down and 7. And a big third down situation right out of the chute here in the second half for California. Back to pass, O'Neal. He felt the rush, threw it for Tate, incomplete. In and out of the hands of his tight end. Right there with him, step for step, was Dante DiPaolo. And now, Oregon will have to punt it away as the Bear defense shows its muscle on its first defensive series of the second half.
Willie Tate, the Bears trying to put a hurt on him for those two touchdown passes. Good pressure here on Danny O'Neal. Regan Upshaw, Dwayne Clemens put the hurt on him. Great coverage by Dante DiPaolo. Kind of has that hand on the back side of him where the ref can't see it, and does a good job defensively.
Now Tommy Thompson to punt. He's got his shoe back on. Matt Quisby back deep for California. Be just a second punt of the afternoon. And California trying to turn the tide here in the second half. Here comes the rush. They almost get it, but not quite. Quisby will signal fair catch back at the 37-yard line and makes the catch there. The Bears got one last week, and they tried to come that time, but were just a little bit short of blocking that punt.
Artis Houston. Again, last week we saw him block one, and they got the touchdown off of it. He is always in their hustle. I mean, for a guy that starts at the corner and then gets plays on all the special teams, that he has been, I think, a surprise for the Bear coaching staff. Probably the best cover guy the Bears have out in that defensive backfield.
Well, let's see what the Bears talked about at halftime. It's first down and 10 for Cal at its own 39-yard line. See what type of adjustments California made, because the first half was all Oregon. Ball. The rush comes, but he gets the ball out to Chapman. Chapman across the 40 with some running room to midfield. He's to the 40, still on his feet. He might go. 10, 5, touchdown, California. A 61-yard touchdown play from Dave Barr to Lindsey Chapman, as Chapman weaved his way in and out of the traffic. And just like that, the Bears get some life here in the second half as it's 30-13.
Lindsey Chapman is the designated rally starter, boy. I tell you, that was a great play.
Bears taking advantage. Chad Cota, the strong safety, is, I guess you could say, he's getting some nose problems. He wants to get up there and defense the run. Bears did a good job there against an eight-man front of dumping it off to Lindsey out in the open field. Tough to bring him down.
Bryant for the extra point. It's up and good. So a long road back for California, but a big step taken there. 13:49 left in the third quarter. It's Oregon 30 and California 14. California on the board here in the second half, and this is actually considered a 61-yard run. That was technically a lateral from Dave Barr to Lindsey Chapman, but watch him pick his way through the traffic here.
Frank Beatty got out quick to get that initial cutback or the kickout block, and you get Lindsey Chapman in the open field, and he can just work miracles, and he gets out here. Great touchdown pass reception.
Let's go down to Glenn Kuiper. Glenn, that's going to change the momentum a little, I imagine.
Oh, yeah. Thanks a lot, Joe. You know, sometimes when your team's down by 23 points at halftime, that first drive of the second half can be oh so important. Most of the time, you'd like a nice, long drive, but nothing wrong with a big play. 61 yards to Lindsey Chapman. That's exactly what the Bears needed.
And the Bear defense made a statement as they stuff Oregon on its first possession of the second half. And now the Bears are trying to do the same thing here as Bryant kicks it off. This one coming down to Whittle, about a yard deep in the end zone. Whittle brings it out. And again, Nady had the initial hit on him. Crispy dragged him down short of the 20-yard line. Now, first and 10 for Oregon, and this place has come alive as the Bear defense will try to stop the Ducks here and get the ball back. Shedrick and Burwell, the backs behind O'Neal. O'Neal pitches it out to Burwell. He's got some running room to the 25, but then the Bears gang tackle him short of the first down.
You go airborne and then and you get crushed.
I think that was a smart call, though, because it was a safe call. O'Neal wanted to just try to do something where he could get some yardage and get out of that hole a little bit.
He's going against the strength of the offense. The tight end is to the opposite side, so they're actually going into the short side of the field. He just pitches it out there. And here he is going airborne and just getting spanked by Eric Zumwalt and company.
The Bears with a touchdown in the second quarter and then one here early in the third. And again, Memorial Stadium rocking. Shedrick has the first down out across the 30 to the 33. And it'll be first and 10 for the Ducks.
Nice play by the Ducks. You know, Burwell and Whittle are getting a lot of the carries here. You create a little diversion here and give it to a guy like Juan Shedrick, who's strong. He's 230, not to mention a good blocker, and they pick up good yardage here. Just to connote, Rich Richardson's in at corner now, so we're seeing a little rotation out there at that left corner for the Bears.
Richardson on the left corner, the bottom of your screen right now, as O'Neal goes back to pass on first down. Throwing long for McLemore, has him out there, and has the catch inside the 25-yard line. They went immediately after Richardson. It was number six on number six out there. Kristen McLemore for Oregon against Rich Richardson, and that'll take the steam out of you real fast.
Wow, I tell you what, Jody Graham, Ike Booth, and now Rich Richardson are over at that left corner. And he just, you know, he plays it pretty well. He's just a step behind it. Really a nice throw there by Danny O'Neal to get it out there. And a nice catch over his head. Gets his foot in. That's a big play.
A 42-yard pickup, and O'Neal put that in a perfect place. The only place it could be for the receiver. First and 10 for Oregon. Bears showing the blitz. Here comes Burwell. Burwell may go all the way to the end zone. He does. Touchdown, Oregon. The Bears kind of gambling with the blitz, and when you do that, when you get past that first wave, there's not anybody in the secondary to stop you, and Sean Burwell comes up with a touchdown, and I would say the Ducks answered very decisively there after Cal had grabbed the quick momentum in the third quarter.
Yeah, you got it, Joe. You know, when you get inside the 20, teams anticipate blitzes, and both guys, inside backers coming in, Joyner and Willard, and Burwell gets past the line of scrimmage, and nobody touches him.
A 13-yard run by Burwell, and that quiets everyone. 11:18 left in the third quarter. Still lots of time, but Oregon negates that last touchdown by the Bears.
You see Artie shaking his head there, and that's the price you pay sometimes when you gamble. You just create huge voids there. And a back like Burwell has got big play potential on every down.
And the Ducks will go for two here as they put three wide receivers to the right. And O'Neal looks like he's changing the play. They give it to Burwell, and Burwell gets in for the two. So Burwell gets in for the two right in front of the contingent from Eugene, who made it down here for this ball game, and they are on their feet and clapping, and it's 38-14 now. Oregon leading with 11:18 left in the third quarter. Well, now let's see if California can regain a little bit of the magic that Lindsey Chapman ignited a few minutes ago. It's 38-14, Oregon. And not only was that touchdown negated, the Ducks also added a two-point conversion. So in that exchange, they got one more point out of the whole thing than the Bears did. Thompson kicks it off. Benjamin will take it 2 yards deep in the end zone, and now he has to run it out. Couldn't make up his mind what he wanted to do, and he'll be stopped all the way back at the 5-yard line. He started out, and then Houston told him to stay, but by that time he looked like he was right about at the goal line, and he couldn't take a chance on downing the ball there.
Now, you know, he wants to make a big play, and he wants to get out of there. He's only really 2 yards deep. If you're back there, you've got to get in front of the guy and say no. I know you make a step across there, and you're committed.
And Rutherford tries to get around the corner, gets out to the 20. And Dante Lewis makes the stop. Looked like he might have had a face mask there, but no call.
That's similar to the play where Lindsey Chapman got a big run. Chad Cota, the strong safety for the Ducks, is really, well, you talk about a guy, a strong safety that comes up and forces the play. He is not only the leading tackler for the Ducks, but he's played and took almost every snap last year. He kicks out that block and forces Reynard back in. And Dante Lewis from the free safety position comes in and makes the tackle.
Bar, the pass, has Caldwell out there, makes the catch at the 40, and then stopped right near midfield. Again, Woods on the coverage along with Lewis. And just look at the hands on Caldwell's part here.
You ever see him catch with his body? I don't think so. He's you get him bump and run, and the nice thing about it is he doesn't raise his hands until the ball's right in front of him, and it doesn't give Lamont Woods enough time to react. But, you know, he gets his hands on that ball, and it you can't strip it out of there. Mike Caldwell getting big yardage for a guy known as the quote-unquote possession receiver.
29-yard reception. You see how he wrapped the ball up there also to keep anybody from coming in and trying to strip it out. As Barr goes back to pass, looking downfield for Semien, and Semien has it, and he goes in for the touchdown. Semien made the catch at about the 10, and then just kind of waltzed into the end zone. No sense getting in there too quickly, I guess, Damian figures. A 46-yard touchdown pass. And all of a sudden, the Bears able to move the ball offensively. Now the question is, can they stop the Ducks?
Just like a wide receiver to savor the limelight there, just strolls in. And Damian looked so early, I thought that the defensive back, Alex Molden, was going to have time to react, but he didn't. And Damian makes a nice over-the-hand catch and strolls in.
Now Cal will go for a two-point conversion. Barr will work out of the shotgun. Three wide receivers to the right. Throwing for Benjamin, and he is able to make the catch. He had him out there, and I don't know if that just went through Benjamin's hands or if Barr missed him by a little bit, but the two-point conversion is no good. 8:50 left in the third quarter. On offense here in the third quarter, it's Oregon 38, California 20. A 95-yard touchdown drive by the Bears culminated on a 46-yard touchdown pass from Dave Barr to Damian Semien.
Well, Damian is the big play threat that the Bears have out on the perimeter, and he just runs and he turns the opposite way almost, and Alex Molden doesn't react well, and he just strolls in there. Here's the extra point. Dave Barr sees Nile Benjamin open early, and just out of the outstretched arms of Nile Benjamin.
Doug Bryan to kick it off. Ricky Whittle to take it at the goal line. He'll come out to the 10. And he'll be stopped short of the 20-yard line as, again, the Bears special teams do the job. And now the question is, can the Cal defense stop the Ducks? If Cal's going to get back in this ballgame and have a chance to win it, the defense has to either limit Oregon, I would say, to no more points here, or force some type of a turnover to get the Bears a couple of cheap ones.
It appears to be causing some confusion. Danny O'Neal is checking off, and depending on how the Bears play that, They moved that backer out. Now Zumwalt's out there, so their support is out farther.
They go with the pass to Deadweiler, and Deadweiler keeps his feet. Gets out to the 25 to the 28. But another big first down on first for Oregon.
Artie Gigantino put Ike Booth back in at left corner. And they're really working on that side of the defensive, on that side of the corners there against Ike and Rich Richardson and Jody Graham. They've been moving the ball over on that side.
And Shedrick again drives forward, got maybe a yard that time. So it'll set up a big third down situation for the Bear defense here.
Well, Nickel comes in, Marshall Ferran, Gerard Cherry, Kevin Devine in a corner.
Shedrick got a yard, so third down and five. 7:15 left in the third quarter. The 38-20 Oregon lead. O'Neal will pass, throwing for the sideline and incomplete as he got confused that time with his wide receiver, Christian McLemore. McLemore going upfield, and O'Neal expected him to come back for the ball. And the Bears will take over.
You know, you plug receivers into different positions depending on the formation, and Christian McLemore definitely looks like he ran the wrong route there. And prior to the half, boy, he was getting read the riot act out here, one of the coaches, when they were trying to score when they ran out of time. He didn't know where to line up, so he's supposed to have some problems there picking up that offense.
Tommy Thompson into punt. Matt Quisby back deep for the Bears. Here comes a rush again. They got it this time. Zumwalt will take it in for a California touchdown. There's the big one they needed.
Boy, second block punt in two games. And they were lined up. I mean, they didn't disguise anything. Those guys lined right up in it, and the Ducks didn't adjust. And you've got to get into a zone blocking technique when you get that many folks up lined up on the line, and the Bears just did a good job of screaming in there.
Eric Zumwalt picked up the block punt. It was Artis Houston last week. But now Brian will come in to attempt the extra point. And his kick is up and good. 6:55 left in the third quarter. It's now Oregon 38 and California 27. This has all the markings of a wild one. If the third quarter is any indication, the Bears have played one of those already this year against UCLA. First and 10 for Oregon. Winner. Has some running room around the left corner and out near first down yardage just short of the 40 before he's dragged down. That was a slow developing play. The Bears almost got Ricky Whittle behind the line of scrimmage, but he was able to find a hole and make something positive out of it, 11 yards.
Paul Joyner on the left hand side of your screen will come screaming through there now. You know, they're bringing him on a dog. So as you would imagine, that leaves a big void over there on the left hand side. Artie Gigantino is a gambling type defensive coordinator. Likes to bring a lot of pressure.
First and 10 for the Ducks at their own 39. O'Neal. Here comes the pressure. He's able to avoid it and throws incomplete. Wanted to throw for Whittle. The Bears have been able to pressure O'Neal, but he's elusive back there. They haven't been able to sack him.
He's pretty nifty. I wouldn't say he's flat out fast, but he's got enough lateral movement where he can step out of the pressure area. On that play, Christian McLemore was in the slot. Dante DiPaolo and Eric Zumwalt did a good job of playing him in and out. And Danny O'Neal had to bail out.
Bears showing blitz. And I don't know if Cowell's off seat. Well, they let him play it. And O'Neal's going to be dragged down. No penalty flags.
Great call for the Bears. It looked like Reagan Upshaw had stepped over the line of scrimmage.
I didn't know if Cal jumped or if the Bears were pulled off. But we saw that last week as well. A play like that where the ball was kind of snapped about the same time all the movement was happening and the officials didn't call anything. That's exactly what happened here.
You can see the left-hand side. Reagan steps off, but Steve Harden kind of pulls out of there, too. I tell you what we saw that, Joe, was at the end of the Temple game. Those refs just wanted to get the heck out of there. That was it.
Willard is the one who gets the sack. And Tommy Thompson will come on to punt it again. Quisby again back deep for California. They don't come after him this time, and Quisby will just get out of the way as that ball will take an Oregon bounce, and then it takes kind of a funny bounce, goes back the other way, actually, and will be down at the 27-yard line.
You see the Bears huddle on the sidelines. It just makes it a little tougher for the defense. They don't know what personnel is coming into the game, so a little bit of a diversion effect there.
Now Cal with two wide receivers to the right. It's Rutherford and Holly, the backs behind bars. And they give it to Rutherford, who bangs out across the 30 to the 31 or 2. So good pickup on first down. Lindsey Chapman not in there, so the ankle injury keeping him on the sidelines right now.
Good job by Ben Lynch, Eric Malum, and Frank Lee. Those guys getting good surge, just creating enough of a crack where Reynard can just cut through there.
We're inside a minute left in the third quarter. And the Bears not trailing by enough points that they have to just fire it up on every down here. They can run the ball on the ground. They can go back to their original game plan. Rutherford gets out there first down yards before he's tripped up.
I'm going to say it again, but I think, you know, some guys that just don't get a lot of publicity, but Eric Malum at center should be up there with Todd Stussy and some of the other guys around the league. That guy dominates, and he's got such great feet, and they're starting to get surge, and there's some cracks between the center and guard gaps here that the Bears are starting to take advantage of.
First and 10 as Rutherford picked up enough for the first down there. The ball at the 38-yard line. Cal's 38. And Barr will pass it. Rolling out, has Semien out there. He has it at the 40, down the sideline, run out of bounds, finally by Dante Lewis. But the Bears into Oregon territory at the 37.
Well, I tell you what, just little things make big plays, and I think what you see, if you look at the tight splits, you can't tell here, on the offensive lineman, it creates a lot of tightness inside, so when Dave Barr bootlegs out and tosses it out, there's just a lot of room to run, but it looked like the offensive linemen were just a little tighter. Fingertip catch here. Damian is doing a good job of holding on to the ball today.
25-yard pickup on that pass as Cal gets to the 37 of the Ducks, first and 10. Little problem with the exchange. They give it to Rutherford. I thought one of the Ducks was offside, but again, one of those kind of crazy plays. There was movement there, and then we saw that they were just going to let him play it.
No flag on the play.
No flag. It'll be second down. But we will have the end of the third quarter as the clock winds on down. One quarter left to play at Memorial Stadium. If the third quarter any indication, the fourth quarter will be a wild one. It is Oregon 38, California 27. Stay tuned, lots more to come. One quarter to play at Memorial Stadium. Hang on, everybody. 38-27, Oregon leading the Bears. Second down and 10 for California. It has been a wild one, and every indication is the fourth quarter be even crazier. Far. Throwing intended for a Wazoke and incomplete.
Well, Dave had to throw the ball a little bit before Ahani was out of his break there, and he was just tough. I think Dave is saying there, you got to come back. You know, what's the depth of your route? They got to be on the same page at this point in the game.
Now California needs 10 yards here. Third down and 10. If the Bears can get in the end zone here, you got a whole different ball game going on.
You kind of start playing that game. Do they go for two, and then that would allow a tie if they got another field goal, or do they just go, you know, hope to get the two touchdowns, obviously.
Stretched out and grabbed that one on his fingertips. But now third down and 5 for the Bears. Barr changing the play at the line. Did the Ducks get back? No penalty flag. Here comes the rush. Barr trying to get away and has to eat the ball back at the 30. 34 is where they'll mark it. There was movement along the defensive line, but it looked like the Ducks got back right before the snap.
And that's about the fifth time we've seen somebody over the, it looked like over the line of scrimmage, and no call.
Now Longwell will have to punt it, and the clock becoming an enemy of the Bears. 8.5 minutes left to play, and Cal still trailing by 11 points. Longwell, a high wobbly spiral. The Brown signals for the fair catch back at his 28-yard line. A 46-yard punt by Longwell. But California's defense with a big test here. 8:22 left to play in the ball game. The Bears need to get the ball back and get it back quickly. Sean Burwell gets around the corner and gets out to the 35-yard line. A big pickup on first down. We'll go downstairs now to Glenn Kuyper. Glenn?
All right, thanks, Joe. You know, I was thinking at halftime, very seldom do good teams play four bad quarters of football. Cal played two bad quarters, obviously, in the first half, but they've showed that they are a good football team. They've come back and played very well here in the second half. And, hey, they're down by 11 points with just under 8 minutes to go. They still got a chance to win this football game.
Up to the defense right now to try to stop Oregon and give the Bears that opportunity. Second down and two after that 8-yard pickup by Burwell. And now Whittle with some running room. He's across midfield. It's a foot race. He's to the 40, the 30, and then knocked out of bounds at the 20. Boy, Oregon has just had the big plays whenever they have needed them. And that run by Ricky Whittle for 44 yards. Takes the ball deep into Cal territory at the 20-yard line.
Center Tom Curran, if you can watch the center, gets a block on Jarrett Willard right there to the left of your screen and knocks Jarrett out. And that's the difference in this play. Whittle's able to get outside. Everybody's engaged, and he's got pretty good wheels. Big play.
Willard goes over the 100-yard mark. O'Neal throwing to the end zone, incomplete. Wanted to go to Detweiler. The break for the Bears, that stops the clock now. 5:59 to play. About all California can afford here is a field goal, and then the Bears would be trailing by 14.
You see two different quarterbacks signaling in the plays there, and you got to believe that's for Denny Shuler. Maybe Denny is retained some of those signals. So they've got the extra guy there.
Tony Graziani was number 10. Ryan Perry Smith, number 17, number 2 and 3 in the depth chart behind Danny O'Neill for the Ducks. Second down and 7. Or goal from the 7, and they give it to Whittle, and Whittle gets it back to the 5. But what the Bears have to do here is force the Ducks into a field goal try. That would put them down by 14, and they still have a shot.
Go for that 2-point conversion for the win.
If Oregon goes in for a touchdown here, it's pretty much over. Clock rolling now. We're down to the 5.5-minute mark. Third down and goal from the 4. For the Ducks. O'Neal back to pass. Looking to the end zone and incomplete pass.
Boy, and if you're a receiver coming across the middle there when linebackers aren't really dropping that deep, Paul Joyner put the wood on.
It was McLemore, Kristen McLemore, right at the goal line and was unable to hang on to the ball.
And if you're going to do that, you've got to settle in between guys. You can't run blindly across the zone because somebody's going to come and knock your clock off. Great play. Now watch across. He doesn't settle. He just runs across like it's man-to-man. And Joyner does a great job of just stripping the ball out of there. Jars it loose.
So Tommy Thompson will attempt a 21-yard field goal. And his kick is up and good. So it's now a 14-point ball game. 5:11 left to play at Memorial Stadium. Thompson's field goal gives Oregon a 41-27 lead. Well, the hill for California made a little bit steeper after that field goal by Tommy Thompson. The only saving grace for California out of that was that the Ducks didn't get in the end zone. Total yardage the Cal defense has given up today. That far exceeds anything the Bears have done previously this season. And Nile Benjamin will take this kickoff at his own 2-yard line, trying for a good return. Gets past the first wave. He's still on his feet. Oh, he needed to get past one more tackler. He had only the kicker between he and the end zone.
And I tell you, the two deep guys, now Benjamin and Artis Houston, are thinking one thing, big play. They have got that on their mind before Thompson kicks that thing off, and that was a great play. The wall set up, and he was able to get through and make a big play. The Bears have got pretty good field position.
Tyrone Edwards and Raynard Rutherford, the backs behind Barr, who wants to throw it on first down. Going long downfield, has Semien out there. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown, California. Barr threw a 72-yard touchdown pass to Damian Semien. Had him out there behind everybody. And don't count the fans out of this one yet.
Dave Barr throwing that on a scramble, and they came out in an obvious zone coverage. He drops back, was looking for Mike Caldwell. Mike really never found the lane. Damian kept running down the middle of the field. He didn't settle up. He just kept working, kept working. Dave Barr was able to get loose and wings it.
Ryan's extra point is good. So 4:53 left to play in the ball game, and it's now a 41-34 ball game. Well, that drive took a long time, didn't it?
That's what the doctor ordered, a couple seconds.
Exactly. Oregon scored with 5:11 to play, and the Bears come right back with 4:53 to play. So it took them 8 seconds.
You talk about improvising. Dave Barr just gets back here. He's waiting for Mike Caldwell to sit in one of those zones, but Mike is kind of in a tweener position. He steps up. Look at Damian staying inside, away from that free safety. And Dave Barr, because he's got such a strong arm, I mean, God, he's able to throw it 60 yards down the field and get to Damian to it. Boy, the key, you know, that drive just didn't take any time. If you could, that's what the doctor ordered, boy. First play, boom, touchdown.
Now, Oregon will be in a position where the Ducks want to grind the ball out. They don't want to be too predictable, but they don't want to take any chances either, because if they turn the ball over in this type of situation.
Kickoff return team is up in anticipating a squib here.
Ryan kicks it deep, and that'll chase Little back in his own end zone, and he'll fall down there to down it. And Oregon will have it first and 10 at its own 20. After Cal fell behind 30 to nothing, the Bears have come back to make it a cliffhanger. Movement, but the Bears get back. First and 10. They give it to Whittle. And Whittle with some running room to the 30. Down the sideline to the 40 and out to midfield. I thought they had that play pretty well advanced, but Whittle was able to keep his feet and picks up 30 yards out to midfield.
Well, for a guy that came into the game with a pretty serious groin pull, wasn't anticipating a play, and he breaks a couple tackles here. You see, good. Regan Upshaw gets blocked. Mike Davis gets knocked down. Jarrett Willard, looks like he misses, and Whittle is off to the races here. And watch this. You don't see that too often. Eric Zumwalt takes the blow from Ricky Whittle.
Whittle, 10 carries now for 101 yards. So both Burwell and Whittle over the 100-yard mark today. Biggest comebacks in Cal history. Relatively recent in Cal history, have both been 21-point efforts. The ball at the 43-yard line of California. Third down and 3. Kulo Malapai comes in to replace Shedrick at the fullback position. Whittle is the tailback. And they'll pitch it out to Whittle, trying to get around the corner. Did not get the first down. Willard came over to knock him down as he tried to cut it upfield, and Thompson will come in as the Ducks will have to punt.
Well, they've got that split tight end. They brought him in motion to crack down on Dwayne Clemens. Dwayne did a good job. Let's take a look at it. You can see the tight end Whittle comes down, cracks on Clemens, knocks him out, but look at Joyner. Joyner's right there. Look at Willard coming in at the top of your screen. Boom, tackle, no first down. It's 4th and 1.
So Thompson will punt it away. Quisby and Benjamin will be back deep for California. Willard's numbers today. 85 yards to go before anybody has to make this decision. But I'll give you a chance to think about it ahead of time. Do you go in for the 2 or do you kick the extra point to tie it?
Go for the win.
Barr again from the shotgun. Rolling away from trouble. Looking for Semien. Has him break it open, but no. Throws it complete to Owazoke and has the first down out at the 31. Semien and Owazoke were in the same area right there. Semien broke out of the way and Owazoke made the catch as Barr tossed it to him.
Well, Semien and Caldwell on the close side to the right-hand side of your screen. Caldwell's downfield. There's Danny Ahanias comes right into the fold right there, and they talk about Dave Barr not being able to throw the, on the run. Just a great job there.
First down, he throws and complete to Semien, who gets out of bounds and stops the clock and does pick up the first down. And again, if you're Oregon, you want to keep everything in front of you, so that's going to give the Bears opportunities to pick up little chunks of yardage like that.
You know, defensively, if you're the Ducks, you want to play coverages that take away the outside, forcing everything inside so those guys can't step out of bounds. Bears are just doing a good job of hitting the guy, getting out of bounds, and saving time.
Now three wide receivers to the left for the Bears. Holly, the lone running back, comes in motion to the right. And Barr to pass it, trying to roll away from trouble. Now has a big lane, he'll run. Took it out of bounds as he gets into Oregon territory. Goes out at the 48.
Smart play, doesn't throw it downfield where he doesn't feel like he's got a good lane to throw. Most importantly, gets out of bounds. Take a look. He only takes a three-step drop. I'd like to see him get back there a little deeper just to take some pressure off the offensive lineman, but not really, really good coverage there, and gets positive yardage, gets out of bounds. Second and short.
Second down and eight, or two, I should say, after pickup of eight.
We're looking there at Nick Aliotti, defensive coordinator, took over for Denny Shuler.
They keep it on the ground, bang it out to Holly. He's to the 40, has the first down, and down to the 40-yard line of the Ducks.
Boy, you see that block by Todd Stussy in the middle. And I guess he's as big as he is. He's pretty easy to run into, but he just engulfed the defensive player there and a lot of room to run.
Holly's first carry of the day, a big one. First and 10 for the Bears at the 40-yard line of Oregon. Barr to throw it on first down along the sideline for Semien. Has it and out of bounds at the 30.
That's a big league pro right there. Stephanie's on the far hash side. And Semien's to the wide side of the field, steps back. It doesn't even step into it. Look at where it is. Perfect.
Right on the money.
Perfect.
Just a reminder that the Stanford-Notre Dame game coming up right after this one on Sports Channel. 1:36 left to play in the ball game. Cal with the ball at the 30-yard line of Oregon. Still two timeouts left for the Bears. Barr from the shotgun. Throwing complete. And that time they had him covered very quickly as he threw to Semien. And the Ducks closed in a hurry. Dante Lewis and Alex Molden.
I think the Bears, if they're going to throw it, they should throw it here where they're on the 27-yard line where the receivers have got some areas to work. It gets tougher to throw as you get in closer.
Barr on the shotgun. Throwing for the end zone, just as you said. He's got the receiver there. Touchdown, California!
Two here. Dave Barr getting directions from Gilbertson. You gotta believe they're gonna go with something that's gonna give him an option. Where he's got, you know, Dave maybe has a couple different options, either to throw the ball, sprint out.
Here it is.
Fielder for a pin.
41-40 ball game. Barr will try the 2-point conversion. Changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Has Holly and Rutherford, the backs behind him. Wants to pass it, throws the fade to Caldwell. Did he catch it? Penalty on the play. A penalty on the play as they threw the fade. And it's good anyway. It's good anyway.
He was in.
The 2-point conversion is good.
Right there, 30-0 deficit, and on an audible play.
Is that a gutty call? A gutty throw to put that up there on a fade pattern. Here's the touchdown from Dave Barr to Ihane Awazike.
Just outruns Alex Molden, and he's been beat basically like a drum all day, and he gets a step, and Dave Barr does a great job of just rearing back and putting it perfectly where the defender can't get the ball, and a great catch. That's a lot of concentration for Ihane. Okay, here's the two-point conversion, just a fade, which he checked off to Mike Caldwell. See how he uses his body to screen off the defender? And so if it's his momentum that takes him out, the catch is good, even though there is a defensive cut. They call face guarding.
Yeah, there's no question about the fact that Woods was riding him all the way out there. And then the official who came from a little farther down the sideline threw the flag on the interference. Then they said that Caldwell also did get the foot down as he was coming down with the ball. So now a penalty as well was called at the end of that two-point conversion because the Oregon defenders were in the official's face a little too much there at the end of it. So now Brian will kick off from midfield. But you know, this is no guarantee with a minute 17 left to play either.
And they've got two timeouts left. There's a lot of time, so you've got to hope that maybe Dave Barr, Doug Bryan will try to line drive this thing so it's not an automatic touchdown. They've got such great field position as he's kicking off from midfield.
Touchback, you mean.
Touchback, excuse me.
Yeah, that's all right.
I lost my composure here for a minute.
Don't you doubt on me now. It's the final minute, 17 to go. And Bryan will just kick it out of the end zone. And they're going to tell, that was good, by the way. It went through the uprights there. So now they're just going to tell Oregon, all right, you got it on your 20. If you can move it against us, you deserve it. And what an incredible comeback by California, which trailed 30-0 in this ball game, and the Bears now lead it 42-41 with 1:17 to play. Memorial Stadium going crazy. Danny O'Neill back to pass. He'll run it, keep it in the middle of the field, and the Bears get him at the 25.
Bears want to keep those guys in bounds. Clock is running.
We're down to a minute left to play. Oregon still has two timeouts to use. Inside a minute now. O'Neill trying to get a playoff, and that's got to be hard to do in this crowd right now. Back to pass. Throwing along the sideline. Incomplete. Wanted to go for Ricketts over there. And now it'll be a third down and 5.
Well, in this crowd in the game right now, Joe, it's so tough for O'Neill to check off. You saw Steve Hart in the left tackle. He stands up. He can't hear anything. So it makes it really tough when the crowd gets into it. And that's what the Ducks did in the first half is they took the home field crowd out of the game.
So now the most important thing for the Ducks, try to get the first down here. But we are, of course, in four down time as they will try again if they don't get it here. But third and 5, they throw across the middle to Deadwater, complete out to the 40 to the 42. And that'll stop the clock until they reset the chains. Oregon still with two timeouts left, 42 seconds to play, and the Ducks will line up.
Well, he does a good job here, O'Neill, getting back, looking to the opposite side, and then hitting Deadwyler.
First down, he throws it up, that'll go incomplete.
Excellent play by Artis Houston. The corners are up in two deep coverage, which means they play the flat and funnel everything outside of him. O'Neill was anticipating him getting in the hole between Dante DiPaolo and Artis Houston. Artis did a great job of just shoving the receiver out of bounds.
35 seconds to play. The Ducks still with their two timeouts. The Bears have come back from a 30-point deficit to lead this game. O'Neill the pass. They try to go after him. He throws long. Houston's out there. He picks it off. Artis Houston with the interception for California.
Teams, but out in coverage, you know, he's the small guy, 5'8", 180 pounds. These guys watch him on film. They think he can beat him. Just continues to make the big play.
Did you see Rich Brooks take Lamont Woods, his defensive back there, and put his arm around
yeah.
him? Woods got beat both times for both the touchdown and the two-point conversion. And he put his arm around him and told him that. You know, it's not just you. You have a tendency in a situation like that to put it all on your shoulders. And now Barr will down the ball. The Ducks will undoubtedly use their timeouts here and hope for a miracle.
And this has been an outstanding ballgame. And, hey, Cal is for real. I said going into the second half, they showed signs and come back and win this game. Prove that they are a good team. They have done that.
And this should be the final snap. Barr will down it. And now Oregon cannot stop the ball. Incredible.
Rich Brooks can't believe it. This whole Oregon Duck team is in shock.
I haven't seen anything like this at Memorial Stadium since the play. The last time they had a game like this was when people were running over Stanford trombone players.
You know, the end of the second quarter, you just knew, you know, it was just such an uphill battle, but the tempo was set on the first series that the Ducks had the ball when Wiley, the tight end for the Ducks, you know, got hurt. That was just kind of the tempo setter right there. Everything went the Bears' way.